Meghan Markle's latest speech was seen as a veiled criticism of the royal family, an expert has claimed. The Duchess of Sussex appeared via video for the Vax Live charity concert, which raised funds for coronavirus vaccine deliveries to other countries. Meghan praised the delivery of vaccines during the concert, and referenced her and Prince Harry's second child, which will be a girl. In a pre-recorded video, Meghan said the world deserves to heal together from the COVID pandemic. The Duchess added how she and Harry are thrilled to be welcoming a daughter. She said, "It's a feeling of joy we share with millions of other families around the world. When we think of her, we think of all the other families around the globe who must be given the ability and support to lead us forward. Their future leadership depends on the decisions we make and the actions we take now to set them up and to set all of us up for a successful, equitable, and compassionate tomorrow." Writing for news.com.au, royal expert Daniela Elsa suggested Meghan's reference to families supporting each other was another shot at the royal family. Referencing Meghan's comments about her daughter, the expert said, "That of course is a lovely, heartwarming sentiment which any right-minded person would wholly throw their weight behind. It also happens the particular wording here could be interpreted as something of a veiled criticism of the palace." The expert then pointed to the Sussex Royals interview with Oprah Winfrey, where the Duchess claimed she was not protected as a member of the firm. Meghan alleged in her interview with Ms. Winfrey in March that she naively believed, "I'm being protected," and later came to understand that not only was I not being protected, but that they were willing to lie to protect other members of the family. The Duchess also said during the interview, "My regret is believing them when they said I would be protected." Ms. Elsa said in her article, "Given this particularly loaded situation, it would make perfect sense if, even now, that lack of assistance and succor is still something of a serious sore point for Meghan. While no man is an island, no woman, no matter how much of a go-getting dynamo, can do everything single-handed. In passionately urging that young women must be given the ability and the support to lead us forward, sounds a lot like Meghan is calling for girls worldwide to be given the precious commodity she was reportedly denied by the stiff-backed, hide-bound palace." Judy James, a body language expert, also observed Meghan appeared to talk in the style of the Queen during her speech for Vax Live. She said to The Sun, "With the bench she was sitting on looking suspiciously like a plug for her new book, Meghan's body language at the start looked as serene and static as the large cushion beside her, but with a small self-comfort thumb rub gesture to suggest some inner nerves, too. Hers was a floral-clad, maternal-looking charisma, low on passionate gesticulation and high on kind smiles and bump cupping. The regal note appeared verbally too as she sat, upright and elegant, to refer to my husband and I in the style of the Queen, but that cupping gesture that she had also used on Oprah reminded us of her theme about daughters and women of the future." If you liked this video, please hit the like button to give this channel a boost. If you would like to see more royal family news, please hit the subscribe button and hit the little bell to be notified of the future videos.